What is going on, everybody? It's Stas here. Welcome back to another video. So in this video, we're going to be doing an overall market update, and we're going to be talking about one trade that I made today on the 10th of December in 2018. But before we do talk about the topics of today's video, for all you new viewers out there, my name is Stas, and I make videos dealing with swing trading, day trading, long-term investing, and my personal philosophies and strategies when it comes down to investing and trading in the stock market. So for those of you guys that want to learn more about that, feel free to drop a like, leave a comment, and subscribe, and follow me on Instagram as well as on Twitter, and join our Discord group chat as well as our Facebook group. All of those are linked down below in the description box. And if you guys want to be in contact with me and about 330 other investors and traders, join that Discord group chat, guys. We're talking on a day-to-day basis about trading, stocks, investing, philosophies, news, you know, strategies, and just networking with each other, again, on a day-to-day basis. So if you guys want to be a part of it in the Facebook, the Discord, the Instagram, and the Twitter, again, all of those are linked down below in the description box. So let's talk about what is going on right now in the overall stock market. So I'm recording this video with about 1 hour and 10 minutes left. So a lot of things can happen in an hour and 10 minutes. So let's take a look at it, guys. So in terms of the Dow Jones, we're up about $10 right now, up about 0.04%. But don't let this fool you guys, because for those of you that have been paying attention to the markets today, the Dow is actually down about 500 to 600 points at one point, more towards the beginning of the market. So we can see that here on the 1 day, 1 minute, guys. We closed this past Friday at about 24,400. And we can see from that point, guys, we sold off all the way to 23,800. So about a 500 to 600 point drop in terms of the Dow Jones. And this is actually where I was able to profit on the ETF that I traded today. And we're going to talk about that in a couple of minutes here. But, you know, big sell-off, and then we had a strong rebound heading into, you know, with 1 hour left into the market, left in the market today. So very strong rebound, guys. We had about a 500-point swing back up. And, you know, the Dow Jones and the overall markets have been doing this. Do you guys remember the past couple of days ago, we had a very big drop? I think it was this day. We had a big drop from 25,000 all the way down to 24,300. That was a 700-point drop. And we literally swung all the way back up 700 points to close that day. So these swings that we've been seeing, guys, they've been happening, you know, a lot recently. So, you know, be careful with the volatility in the market, because it's been really volatile since the beginning of October. But looking at the broader perspective here on the 180 chart in terms of the Dow Jones, we're making lower highs like I've been talking about in the previous videos. And now that we broke below this support here at about 24,500, we broke below that today with the 500-point drop that we saw early on in the trading day. You know, we're now making a lower low and pretty much breaking out of this horizontal or this support level that we've had over the past couple of weeks. So this is not exactly a great sign, guys, because, you know, if we were able to hold above here and push up 500 points today, that would be good, that the Dow could potentially be reversing. But the fact that we broke below here, guys, continuing this lower low, you know, lower high pattern, it's not looking too good. And we can take a look here. Let me just quickly clear this drawing set so I can draw this channel out for you guys. And if you guys want to learn how to draw a channel, very simple. Come up here, drawings, drawing tools, and then you can go right here and click channel. So what we can see right here, guys, let me just show you. This is forming a new channel. So based off of this little channel that I just drew out here for the Dow Jones, you know, we can see this pattern slowly starting to form. It topped at 27K, you know, bottomed out here at about 24,000, popped up here to 26,200. You know, it stopped here a little bit at about 24,200, popped up, got rejected, and now we're pushing down again towards that bottom channel. So I do see potential, guys, that You know, the Dow Jones will be, you know, trading in this channel based off what the technicals are currently telling us. And obviously, this is a downwards trending channel. And what we would want to see for a break of pattern would be ideally that we break out of first this resistance point at about 25,800. The next one at about 26,200, and then obviously eventually the 27,001, but we are pretty far off from there. And, you know, we got to just wait step by step and, you know, count the resistance points and see whether or not the Dow is going to break out of them to determine if this one is reversing in pattern. So that's what the Dow Jones is looking like, guys. You know, now that we're, you know, we've been recording for a little bit, it's actually turning red, down about 54 points, but S&P, very similar situation, although this one's more of in a horizontal pattern than the Dow Jones is. Very clear resistance at about $2,800 to $2,820, right? Very clear support at about $2,630. So if we're able to pop up a little bit tomorrow, guys, you know, this would be a successful bounce on the support in terms of the S&P. But if we do break below here and have another couple of red days in a row, this is obviously putting it into lower low territory, continuing the correction of the S&P. And we're currently down about 3% on the S&P, or actually no, $3 down about 0.1% on the S&P 500. So keep an eye on these levels, guys. The S&P still technically at that support level, so keep an eye on that, and keep an eye on whether or not the Dow Jones is going to, you know, bottom out at the bottom of this channel, or if it's going to break below it, or potentially reverse right here and, you know, start to go back up towards the top resistance point of this channel that we drew out. So the NASDAQ, guys, actually bounced pretty successfully at that support at about 65.50. Now it's testing this next resistance, which is a previous support, at about 66.75. So that's going to be a level we want to see the NASDAQ break above before it does test this next resistance at the 180 and the 50 simple moving averages. So overall today, guys, so far we're up about $40 on this index, up about 0.6%. This is actually one that's performing the best as of right now in terms of the three main indexes that we follow. So with about an hour left, guys, the markets are pretty much flat on the day. We had a big sell-off early on in the day where I was able to profit on a particular ETF that I trade all the time, and we had a big swing back up, putting us at the the break-even point from pretty much right around the break-even point from the close this past Friday. So now that we got a better overall look at the market, let's just quickly talk about the ETF that I traded today. And I'm sure a bunch of you guys can guess what this is. And it is TVIX, guys. TVIX. What a mover today, early on in the day, for TVIX. It was absolutely ridiculous. So I actually entered this trade right before this big push up at about $52.82. I took an initial position there, and you know, once I saw it fly up very quickly, guys, very quickly, as we saw the market sell off early on in the day, I actually did not end up adding more money into TVIX because it already shot up like 4 or 5% within about 20 minutes of me buying in, literally. So I ended up taking my profits at about 4.6%. I sold off actually right around here, I believe. We pulled back here, and then we had a nice little push up, right? You see that. We pulled back, we pushed up, and I ended up selling off at about 55.25, I believe, you know, right at this resistance point right here, because at that point, the markets were already down about 300 points. So I wanted to be safe in terms of the Dow Jones, right? We were down 300 points, and I wanted to be safe, you know, in terms of taking my profits, because as we can see, guys, from 52.82, I was up about 4.6% at around that price point, right? 4.6 puts it at right about like 525, like I said, right? So from that point, guys, you know, I ended up selling off. We pulled back again to $53 and had another massive run back up to $58. So if I actually were to hold, you know, until this peak, I would have made 10% on my position. And it's been a while, guys, since I've actually made like 10 to 15% on a position because I'm always being conservative. I'm always, you know, locking in my profits at around the 3 to 5% range because that's my daily goal. And once I hit that, I like to lock in and then stop trading for the day because I find that if I overtrade, sometimes I give the money back to the market and that just like messes with my mental, right? And I'm sure a bunch of you other traders out there can relate to this, right? You hit your daily goal one day and then you see another opportunity later on in the day potentially and then you take a loss on that. It really sucks because you locked in your profits and then you gave it back to the market, which is never a good feeling. So, you know, I like being conservative, guys. I like locking in my profits and then just watching the stock market for the rest of the day, talking to the people in the group, you know, networking and all of that, you know, jazzy stuff that we like to do. So TVIX, guys, my only trade today, 4.6%. Let's go over some other ones that were completely, you know, they went bananas today, right? You know, they went bananas. Let's take a look at DRIP, guys. This is one that went bananas, right? This one was down to $10 this past Friday, and we've literally ran up 35%, you know, in terms of one day, right? I traded DRIP this past Friday for about 6-7%, I believe it was. For those of you guys that watched the video, you saw that. And today, guys, we literally opened up at 12 and ran all the way up to 1376, another 12% move in terms of DRIP. So honestly, guys, I'm actually looking to play Gush tomorrow. So Gush is the inverse to DRIP, and I was talking about these two in yesterday's video. Ended up not trading either one. I missed the DRIP wave because I was really focusing on TVIX today. And you know, now that we shot up 12%, I potentially see some consolidation in DRIP tomorrow and the next day, followed by a little pullback back to this 50 simple moving average. I think that is very, very possible in my personal opinion, because, you know, check it out, guys. Every time we've shot up to a new high, we've pulled back. And on each of these pullbacks, that's a great opportunity to swing trade or day trade Gush for one day or hold it for a couple of days if that's, you know, if that's what you guys like to do. And, you know, now that I see it's popped up here, I do see potential, guys, especially since the RSI is showing it's a little bit overbought right now. I do see potential in a pullback in, you know, DRIP and Gush, guys. Look how oversold it is. So the fact that we pushed down to 1190, I do see potential back up to that 50 simple moving average here on the 180 chart, giving it about 20%. And am I saying it's going to go up 20%? It's probably not, guys, but the whole idea is to capture some of that if it does show a sign of a reversal tomorrow, pre-market hours, excuse me, or maybe even, you know, heading into power hour right now in the stock market. So Gush, DRIP, you know, they've been on fire, guys. You know, both of them have been flying up 10% one day. You know, the other one's been flying down 10%, you know, the next day. It's just been, you know, really back and forth in terms of these two ETFs. But again, I'm focusing on that bounce back potential on Gush. So another one that I've been watching, guys, is not JNUG, the inverse to this one, which is JDST. JDST, guys, you know, I've been talking about this in yesterday's video and the previous one. We've been, you know, holding above this critical support today at $68, which is a very good sign and what I wanted to see before considering a position in this ETF. And take a look at Slash GC, guys. This is one that is clearly reversing right here on the 180 chart. We see a bunch of red candlesticks forming, and I do see potential for this one to fall back to this 50 simple moving average support level, which has been a support in the past, as we can see, which gives it about an $8 drop, you know, $8 range, in my personal opinion, that we can fall. And if we look a little bit closer on the 20 day, you know, we're slowly breaking below the 50 SMA. You know, if we do end up breaking below here, this is a good sign that this can fall to the 180 SMA on the 20 day chart, giving JDST a very solid opportunity in my personal opinion. So, you know, heading into these next couple of days, guys, I'm really going to be focusing on the market ETFs and the inverse ETFs. I know this gets a little bit repetitive, but, you know, I stick to what works, and that is what works for me, guys. Literally, every single day, I've been trading in and out of these ETFs, in and out of these market ETFs, these velocity ETFs, these volatility ETFs, the, what are they called, the Direxion, I can't even pronounce it, but you guys know what I'm talking about. These ETFs have been very volatile. They're flying up, they're flying down. The market ETFs have been ridiculously volatile. And, you know, I've been able to capitalize on those every single day. Obviously, I've taken some losses, right? But, you know, the profits that I've been taking, the percentage that I've been making money on, really outweighs what I've been losing. So that means that I'm successful in this, and, you know, I'm sticking to these sets of ETFs. And why would I change something that works, right, guys? So I'm sure a lot of you guys can relate. You stick to a bunch of the same ones all the time and consistently profit off them. So that's what I'm personally going to be doing, guys, tomorrow. At the top of my watch list, definitely JDST. It's looking very good. You know, definitely TVIX, TQQQ. If we do have a bounce back day tomorrow to the upside, TQQQ is going to be a very good play in my personal opinion, right? Let me just pull the chart up for you guys. TQQQ, very good play in my personal opinion. If we do end up breaking out of this 50 simple moving average of resistance here on the 20-day chart, you know, TVIX could very well run tomorrow again. Who knows, guys, right? Because the markets have been very unpredictable, very volatile. And the whole idea here is to catch a move, pretty much judging off of pre-market hours, where the markets are pointing. And that's really going to help you, you know, catch a pretty good move on these market ETFs, these inverse ETFs, all these ETF stocks that we've been trading on this channel. So, you know, heading into tomorrow, guys, TVIX is actually on a pullback right now. And this is a very good sign, because when we pull back heading into the close, that opens up margin for the next day. So 8%, 9%. Let's say we do open up right around here tomorrow and the markets are selling off. You know, $54 up to $58, that's about 7-8%. And that's a pretty good trade for a day, in my personal opinion. So TVIX, guys, definitely at the top of my watch list. And that's pretty much it for the rest for this video. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, feel free to drop a like, leave a comment, and subscribe. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter, all the Discord links, the Facebook links down below. I'll catch you guys in there. Hope you enjoyed. Have a great trading week. Great night. Peace out.